Want to learn engineering and science? Well, you've tuned in to the right channel. Hit subscribe and press the bell icon and never miss an update from us.
Hi there guys, how are we doing? This is your friend and tutor Manas, and we'll be continuing today with our discussion on trusses. Now the method that I've picked up basically is what you call the method of sections. So let's see what this particular problem has in store. Here we go. It goes like this. A plane truss is supported and loaded as shown in the figure. Find the axial force in member CD, EF and CF with the method of sections. Okay, now I've already told you before applying method of sections to find the axial forces in members CD, CF and EF, you need to go ahead initially and find the reaction at supports. And if you watch carefully, over here we have sort of a hinged support, okay, and hence there are going to be two reactions, something of this sort. All right, if I can just name them, I'm going to write over here, let's say this is point A, and there is going to be a horizontal reaction at A as well as a vertical reaction at A. And if you watch carefully, over here at point B, we have a roller support, and hence there is going to be one single reaction in the form of RB. Alright, what do we need? We need the values of these three forces, HA, VA and RB. For that, I'm going to be using three equations of equilibrium. If you watch carefully, I'm going to start off with this summation of Fx is equal to 0. So I'm going to be lining up all the forces in the horizontal direction, starting off with HA. Is there any other force other than HA right now? No. So we have got only one single force in the horizontal direction, HA, and that too will be equal to 0. Secondly, we're going to be using this summation of F of Y is equal to 0. If you watch carefully, we've got three forces, VA upwards, RB upwards, and hence both of them positive. So let me write this VA plus RB. Is there any other force? Yeah, we do have 30 kilonewton downward, and hence negative minus 30 is equal to 0. So let me reframe this. We can write this as VA plus RB is equal to 30. Okay, so let's say this is equation number one. Okay, we have to produce one more equation. Okay, so that can easily be done by taking moment about the hinge. So the name of the point at hinge is point A, and let's take the moment about point A and equate it to 0. Now if you take the moment about point A, these two forces will not come into the picture, okay, as they are passing through this point A itself. The forces remaining are this 30 kilonewton and this RP. And if you watch carefully, this 30 kilonewton force produces a clockwise moment at A, and hence a negative sign. Name of the force is 30 multiplied by the perpendicular distance. This is the force, this is the perpendicular distance, that is how much? 2. Okay, so multiplied by 2. And if you watch carefully, about point A, this RB produces an anti-clockwise moment. Okay, so it, hence it has to be given by a positive sign. So this is the force RB upward direction, and this is the perpendicular distance from A to B. That is equal to 2 plus 2 plus 2, that is 6. So RB multiplied by this perpendicular distance dropped from A, that is 6. So let me just write this 6 times of RB. Okay, so guys, you just need to solve this equation. It's pretty easy. 32 is 60, and it should probably work out as RB. Let me write this 10 kilonewtons. And when you put the value of RB is equal to 10 kilonewton over here, so VA will be equal to 30 minus 20, and hence the value of VA shall work out as 20 kilonewtons. So that was all about finding reactions at supports. Okay, now the value of HA is 0. The value of VA is equal to how much? Let me write this again. 20 kN. Okay, what else is there? RB. So RB has been computed as 10 kilonewtons. Now if you watch carefully, this is 2, okay, and this is how much? This is also 2. If you have a careful look at this triangle, I'm going to be finding this angle over here. All right, there is a specific reason why I'm calculating this angle, because the forces in these members are to be resolved, that's why. So what I'm going to be doing is, let us say this angle is alpha. If you want to take tan alpha is going to be equal to opposite, that is perpendicular, CE, that is 2, divided by base, that is EF, which is also equal to 2. So alpha is going to be equal to, let me write this as tan alpha, can be written as CE over EF. And if you watch carefully, CE is how much? 2. EF is also 2. So tan alpha is equal to how much? Is equal to 1. On solving this equation, you're going to get the value of alpha is equal to 45 degrees. That's it. Okay. Similarly, if you watch this triangle over here, and if I can extend this, something of this sort, let us say right now that this point be represented by P, and if you want to take tan theta of this, it's very easy. Let me first erase this. Okay. And let me write this over here, how much this is going to be equal to 45 degrees. All right. Okay. Now we want this angle theta. How can theta be calculated? It's going to be pretty easy. Let me do it over here. Tan theta. Now guys, watch carefully. The side opposite to this theta is this one. This is the perpendicular, right? We are talking about this triangle, triangle CDP. Perpendicular, how much is this? 3 minus 2 will give you the value of DP as 1. 1 over base. So this is the base. CP. Base is how much? CP is equal to EF, and EF is equal to how much? 2. So tan theta is basically equal to 1 by 2. You just need to take an inverse of this. Theta is going to be equal to tan inverse of 1 by 2, and put this into a calculator, and you are going to eventually get the value of theta is equal to 26.56 degrees. So let me write this over here. That's it. Okay guys, let us go ahead and let us try to find the axial forces along CD, CF and EF with the help of method of section. So let me have a section passing through these three members. Okay, here we go. And the forces acting along these members are, here they are, okay, approaching from both the directions, in fact, towards this section line. And let us name them right now. Okay, let's say this force is along member CD. So let's say this is F of CD. This is along CF. Let's say this is F of CF. And over here, let's say this is F of EF, right? So we've got three unknown axial forces, and we have three equations of equilibrium. And I'm going to start off with this equation of equilibrium. Moment about point C is equal to 0. Okay, so the benefit of taking moment about point C is, if you watch carefully, point C is towards the left of the section, and hence forces towards the right of the section are to be considered. These sort of green colored forces and this blue colored force in the form of RB are to be taken into consideration while taking the moment about point C. If you watch carefully, these two forces, that is F of CD from right to left, or from T to C, and F of CF, okay, from F to C, these two forces are approaching point C. You can also say that these two forces are passing through point C, and hence their moments are going to be zero. And hence the two forces that we are left with is this F of EF force, okay, from right to left. This particular force will produce a clockwise moment at C, and hence a negative sign. The name of the force is F of EF, okay, multiplied by, this is the force and this is the perpendicular distance CE, which is equal to how much? 2, right? Now again, if you take the moment about point C for this particular point RB, that is 10 kN, this force tends to produce an anti-clockwise moment at C, okay, and hence a positive sign. Name of the force is RB. All right, RB is how much? 10 kN. We know that very well. So let me write this 10 kN multiplied by how much? Let me try to make the line of action of this force. So this is the line of action, and if I can extend the line of action, yeah, something of this sort. This is the line of action of 10 kN force, and this is the perpendicular drop, okay, something of this sort, perpendicular drop. So force into perpendicular distance will give you the moment. So the force is 10, perpendicular distance is this much, that is 2 plus 2, which is equal to how much? 4. Let me get rid of this. Okay, so 2 plus 2 is how much? 4. Yeah, so 10 cross 4 is equal to 0. You just need to solve this equation, and you're going to eventually get the value of F of EF is equal to how much? 10 cross 4 is 40. 40 by 2 is how much? 20. So 20 kilonewtons is your answer, right? Let me highlight this. Yeah, there you go. Let me again pick a pen with a blue color. Okay, now we've got two more equations of equilibrium in the form of summation of F of x is equal to 0, and summation of F of y also is equal to 0, in fact. Now what we need to do is, I'm going to be considering the left hand side portion of the section. Okay, now these two forces, CF and CD force, both of them are inclined sort of. So they have to be resolved into components horizontally and vertically. So essentially what I'm going to be doing is, let me have the magenta color. Yeah, F of CD has to be resolved into components this way and this way. Okay, now let's name them, right? So this is going to be what you call F of CD cos 26.56, and one more component will be over here. This is what you call F of CD sine 26.56. okay, this is done. What about F of CF? This also is going to have two components, one horizontal while the other vertical. So let me use a blue color for this. Let me use an arrow. Yeah, this way and this way. Okay, now here the angle is how much? 45. All right, so here also this is 45 and this is also gonna be 45. And if you watch carefully, this over here, if I can just try to make this over here, okay, this blue color arrow towards the right hand side, this is what you call F of CF cos 45. This is F of CF cos 45. I'm writing it over here, there is absolutely no space. F of CF cos 45, and one more component in the downward direction in the form of F of CF sine 45. That's it. So let's go ahead, okay, and let's just use this equation of equilibrium. So we have got these two forces, F of CD cos 26.56, F of CD cos 26.56, it's positive because it is towards the right. F of CF cos 45, okay, plus F of CF cos 45, right? Anything else? This F of EF is also there. So let us just write F of EF. Okay, apart from this, is there any other force? I guess no. Okay, so all of this stuff is going to be equal to zero, and I can rewrite this F of CD cos 26.56 plus F of CF cos 45, and F of EF goes over to this side with a negative sign, and F of EF is 20. So had 20 been put up over here, and when it went to the right hand side, it became negative. So minus of 20. So let's just say this is our equation number 2. Okay, so we have to frame one more equation, alright, because we have two unknowns in the form of F of CD and F of CF. Now let's go ahead and let's use this equation of equilibrium. Summation of all the forces in phi direction is equal to 0. Watch carefully, F of CD sine 26.56 upwards and hence positive. Okay, F of CD sine 26.56. okay, apart from this, what else is there? This F of CF sine 45 downwards, negative. F of CF sine 45, okay, this 30 kilonewton also downwards, again negative sign. Now this 20 kilonewton upwards, positive, is equal to 0. Now guys, remember, I'm considering the left hand side portion of the truss. Okay, so the forces over there are to be considered only. Now if I can reframe this equation, I can write this as minus 30 plus 20 will be how much? Minus 10, and minus 10 goes to the right hand side. Okay, you can write this F of CD sine 26.56 minus F of CF sine 45 is equal to 10. So let's say this is going to be our equation number 2. You just need to solve these two equations. Let me highlight these two equations. And on solving them, we're going to eventually get the value of F of CD and F of CF. Okay, let me tell you what those values are. You can do this stuff in a calculator. Basically, it's linear equation in two variables. In place of F of CD and F of CF, you can say you have X and Y. So it's what you call linear equation in two variables, finding the values of X and Y. It's pretty simple. Okay, put this up into a calculator and you can get the values of these two unknown axial forces. Mode, fifth number equation, first one, X and Y, linear equation in two variables, 1. Okay, cos 26.56, cos 26.56, enter. That's it. Cos 45 over here, cos 45, enter. Minus 20, minus 20. Okay, that's it. Done. Sine 26.56, sine 26.56, done. Negative of sine 45, minus sine 45.
-745. Done. And over here 10. Done. Compute. So that's the value of f of cd -7.45. okay, here f of cd -7.45 and f of cf over here in the form of 18.85 -18.85. that's it.
Let me highlight this also. Okay, now if you want to remove this negative sign, you can do so and write compression over here. Okay, and over here you can also remove this negative sign and just write c. okay, which clearly indicates that the members cf and cd, both of them, where are they, cf and cd, both of them are under compression. All right, that's why it has been accompanied with a negative sign. So guys, that was all from my side for today. If you've got any doubt or query, do write them down in the comment section below. I'll be very happy to answer them. And if you believe that this video tutorial has added value to your knowledge of mechanics, then do share and like this video, subscribe to this channel, and recommend this channel to your friends and classmates so that all of them can benefit. I'll be back with more such videos on mechanics and many other subjects and topics. Until then, it's a wrap. This is Manas Patnaik signing off. Take care, have a great day, and keep learning.